Henderson County, 911.
Yes, my wife is shot her kid.
What is her name, sir?
Sarah Henderson.
Sarah Henderson?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, all right, and how old are the children?
7 and 5.
And they're in the bedroom?
Huh?
Are they in the bedroom, sir?
No, they're in the living room.
They're in the living room, and they're not breathing?
No.
Were you home when she did this, or did you just get home?
I was asleep.
You were asleep?
Yes.
God, forgive me, please. Why did I do that, babe?
I don't know.
She's not trying to leave or anything, correct?
She keeps saying somebody's after her. There's nobody after her. There's nothing. She keeps saying people are coming. There's nobody even here.
What did I do, Lord? What did I do? What did I do, God?
Were the children asleep in the living room, or did they get up? Do you know?
They were asleep.
They were asleep in the living room, and then she went in there?
Yes. Okay.
Wearing cowboy boots and tutus, this was Kaylee and Kenley at their mother's wedding. Two young girls, 5 and 7, whose lives were cut short. Investigators say their mother, Sarah Nicole Henderson, shot and killed them.
There's no reason for this. None at all. How could someone do this to them?
Bridget Golds and Jackie Nelms live in Maybank and couldn't stand to sit at home as details unraveled. They brought a stuffed animal and plush doll for the girls.
Makes you want to just get yours and cuddle them and just protect them.
The Henderson County Sheriff says deputies were originally called out for a suicidal woman at the family's home. When they arrived, everyone claimed to be fine. 3 hours later, 911 received a call that a woman shot her kids.
Those little girls were so adorable. They would come over here on their little bicycles with mini wheels and ride around our circle drive.
Jalen Palmer lives across the street from the family. She says she'd hear Henderson yelling at her girls all the time, really loudly, from the porch, but she never heard or saw the behavior go beyond that.
Not easy to even think about. They innocent little girls, it breaks our heart.
When there are no words, there often is prayer. That's all most can do right now.
I just ask God to cuddle them and love them and keep them in good hands up there with them, and it's just so sad, so sad.